Last but not least, Paper Cup. This song was really, 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 really close to not coming out. And I was really, really close to not even showing the band. This felt like a song that I truthfully wrote for myself. It felt like the journal entry version of a song. And I struggled a lot with sending it or not sending it. And then I think one day I just sent it in the group chat and was like, hey, this is a song that I wrote and it's really special to me. And they really kind of accepted it and were like, whoa, this is powerful. And I think that's what happens when, you know, this song was written in probably 8 minutes. It just poured out of me. And I was definitely in a place in my life. I've never felt lower being in this band, being in this industry, feeling like I'm not entertaining the way I should, or I'm not fitting the mold that fits the success that I'm supposed to have. And I was struggling a lot with patience and, you know, just kind of, I felt like I was in this waiting game and things are happening to the band, but like, they don't feel like what I thought they would feel like as a kid. And it's just this complete internal struggle with wanting to be successful, but kind of not understanding why it's not fulfilling the same way that I thought it would. And I think that's any struggle with any artist, any songwriter, anyone that's doing this. It's just, it's a very, very weird game and you have to play difficult cards sometimes and you have to, you know, let go of some cards and you have to sometimes switch decks completely. And like, that's kind of what it feels like. And I'm just really proud of how honest these lyrics are. I was really afraid of putting lyrics like this out in the world. I don't think I've ever been so personal. I think with All the Animals and Seven Stories, I've gotten close in the past with some songs, but this one really feels like word for word what I was thinking. And yeah, I hope people can listen to it and just find some kind of hope in it. I know, as sad as it is, and find some kind of narrative that can serve their daily life and serve their situation and, you know, at least help them figure out themselves if they're feeling similarly. And yeah, the whole instrumental and production of the song was really enjoyable to do. We like rented out a studio for the day and we recorded this really beautiful piano that actually Daniel Caesar, I believe, used on his record. And it just had this really like woodsy, sad tone to it that just fit the song so well. And then actually the ending of the song is like complete improv. Like Kara just, while I was doing a take, jumped on the kit and just started like banging the drums and like hitting all the drums, and we distorted them and we added that like synth bass in the moment, and that whole outro happened in like literally 2 minutes. Like it just happened, and I'm really, really stoked on that part. I think it just like wraps up the song in a way that you wouldn't expect, because like the song just kind of ends and then all of a sudden it's like, wait a second. And that last part just kind of feels like this like final cry for help, this like final just scream and just being like, hey, like, is anyone listening to what I have to say right now? So that's kind of what that part represents. I'm happy we kind of added it. I find that's a big theme for this era, even with tempo and adding the outro. Sometimes songs just need a little bit more context and a little bit more kind of oomph to really explain what's going on. But yeah, really happy to close the EP with this. It's truthfully the most personal song I've ever written. And yeah, I hope people out there can listen to it and helps them get through the day or get through the year. That just means the world. So that's Paper Cup.